The distinctive skyline of Big D. It's a warm, sunny day in the great state of Texas, and we welcome you to the fifth stop on the Miller Lite AVP Tour today. It's the Sunkist Open here in Dallas. Our championship final should be a good one. Jose Loyola and Kent Stevens going up against Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers. Hi again, everybody. Chris Marlowe and Mike Dodd. Welcome to the first of five AVP telecasts we'll have for you this year on the Deuce. It's been a wild and woolly weekend so far here in Dallas. Single elimination tournament and already some big upsets.
Well, that's the beauty of single elimination. The upsets really count for something. And the biggest upset of the weekend so far, Karrion Johnson losing in the second round. They were in the finals of the last three tournaments, so that's a huge upset. And in single elimination, when you lose, you're gone.
Another team that is gone, Canyon Seaman and Mike Whitmarsh, they didn't have it either.
They lost in the first round to an AVP qualifier from last year. I tell you, it really makes for interesting matchups, and here we have a great final this weekend.
All right, the Sunkist finishers, who's been playing well? Let's start in third place. A couple of teams that had hoped to do a little bit better, Dane Blanton and Eric Benoit-Mawana, they expect to win now, so they were disappointed in third. But a team that had its best finish of the year, Brian Lewis and David Swadek, third place. Congratulations to them.
Fifth place, Rob Heiger, Troy Tanner, they're back together. It's a nice finish, good way to start for them. Ian Clark, Bill Bullion, another fifth place. They've had a few in a row. They're looking to break through. Andres Gomes and Emmanuel, a great victory over Karrion Johnson. And then you go to the ninth place finishers. There's Adam and Karch in very unfamiliar territory. You've got Hanneman and Wong getting together for the first time, and a nice finish for them. You've got Paul Boyd and Adam Jewell, the upset winners over Whitmarsh and Seaman, taking a nice ninth place. And you've got Brian Ivey and Brent Prohoff, pro coming off a knee injury. He's been gone for a year. Nice return for him. And finally, you got Brent Doble and Eric Wirtz. Good to see Wirtz at ninth place.
All right, let's talk about our championship final matchup. Kent Stevens, Jose Loyola, the best team in beach volleyball. They're playing well. They've already won a couple this year.
Well, they've won two in a row in Clearwater and Fort Myers. And the beauty of this squad is they're starting to relax a little bit. They were so tense in Tucson. They took a fifth place. They had to regroup. They said, let's just relax. Let's enjoy volleyball. Let's go out and have some fun. They're having fun. And more importantly, they're playing a lot better volleyball and looking to make it three in a row.
Trying to get by Dane Blanton and Eric Benoit-Mawana, 95-degree heat in the semifinal, and they did. Now, Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers, rookies of the year a year ago. They finished second at Hermosa, the biggest tournament of the year, but they've never won a tournament. What are their chances today?
I think their chances are great. They actually had an easier semifinal match than Jose Loyola and Kent Stevens. They're looking good. They've been consistent all year, taking fifth every tournament. They're hungry. They're ready. They're having a dream season and a dream life playing professional beach volleyball. They want to keep it going.
Both teams are fresh. Both teams are motivated. Stevens, Loyola, Holdren, and Rogers. Kent Stevens is 6'4". 210 pounds, now 29 years old, out of Pacific Palisades, California. And he serves it up, leading 1-0. And that one right down the middle and out of bounds.
They've got the wind behind them right now, Chris, so any little bit off, and that ball's going to sail out of bounds.
Dax Holdren, 6'3", 200, 25 years old. Once again, Holdren and Rogers have never won a tournament. They're serving into the wind on the good side. Here comes Stephens. And Stephens puts it away. Dax Holdren told me a little earlier today that they're going to serve Stephens maybe 60% of the time, but serve tough.
They're going to have to serve tough. They're going to have to serve a lot of aces. They've got wonderful ball control, but they don't have the real physicality to deal with Stephens and Loyola at the net.
Jose Loyola. And they're working on Todd Rogers. Todd Rogers puts it away. Rogers with no shirt, good physique, and the funky-looking glasses. There's Todd, and he will serve.
Todd Rogers back.
Rogers and Holdren are kind of like an old-style team, Si. They pass, and they set with the best of them. They're consistent. They play great defense.
And they've been playing together for a long time, and there's an ace by Rogers. So make the score 1-1.
1-1.
This is the best 2 out of 3 games. The first two games are 2-11. The third game to 6 if necessary. Once again, here's Todd Rogers. They'll try Jose Loyola. And he pounds one through.
And what's very interesting about the 2 out of 3 format, Chris, is that they start the clock at 6 minutes. So even though they're only playing to 11, almost every match that's played well goes to the time and not to the points.
So Kent Steffes, the longtime partner of Karch Karai, and he rolls it out down the middle. Of course, Steffes and Loyola, the favorite in this match. Kent Steffes has won over 100 tournaments in his career, and Jose Loyola with 27 wins. Here's Dax Holmgren.
Come on!
Good play by Holdren and Rogers. Great sprawling defense by Dax. The little pokey by Holdren catches Loyola up at the net. Here's the layout. And Todd has to make sure he doesn't go over on that. And there's another ace serve.
So Holdren and Rogers looking good early. Remember, we changed sides on multiples of four, and the youngsters who have never won a tournament lead at the first side change, 3-1. ESPN2's coverage of the Sunkist Open at Dallas is being brought to you by Miller Lite, who reminds you that anything can happen. And by Honda, the official car of the AVP, now offering a full line of cars, minivans, and SUVs.
We left you with Holdren and Rogers leading 3-1. We now pick up the action at 4-4.
The Sunkist Open in Dallas, Texas. Temperature 96 degrees. This is not Chris Marlowe and Mike Dodd playing weather. It's been hot all weekend, and that has taken the toll on some of the biggies. Looping over and out was Todd Rogers. And Steffes and Loyola get an important point on the bad side.
And there's the key with their blocking ability, with their size at the net. Even though they don't have their best jump serves working for them off the bad side, they can keep pressure on Holdren and Rogers at the net.
Kent Steffes will serve it again. And he serves it wide.
It says 96 degrees on the scoreboard, Chris, but the wind's blowing rather briskly, and that's a refreshing element. And I don't think it's as grueling for the players as it was on Saturday's play when there was not a stitch of wind.
Holdren with the serve. And he's working on Steffes, 5-4. Steffes, cut shot, yes. Now, one interesting thing about the heat, Jose Loyola comes from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. He's been quoted in the past saying, I like hot. Well, if you look at Jose, it's 96 degrees as he gives a pretty nice set to Steffes. Jose wears all black. Doesn't that make you even hotter?
It makes you hotter, but I think for Jose, the hotter the better.
Okay, the hotter the better. He's looking for the intimidating look, maybe like the L.A. Raiders. And Steffes into the bottom of the net. Or now the Oakland Raiders, of course. So Holdren and Rogers will get it back.
Here's a very good, another good point opportunity for Loyola and Steffes. Kent trying to get a little tricky with it, saying, gosh, I wish I would have kept that one in.
There's a play that won't be on his highlight reel. 5-4, Steffes and Loyola leading by a point. Here comes Jose. And it's blocked. Dax Holdren with his second block of this game. And we're tied at 5.
Here you see Jose trying to cut back, Holdren reaching in to the line shot with that one right arm. Watch him press his right arm over here, Cy. And that gets him the block.
If you're wondering about Holdren, he's 6'3", 200 pounds, jumps pretty well. 5-5, here comes Steffes, and that's the shot Mike Dodd was talking about, the loop into the deep corner, and Steffes able to get that ball in the final 5 feet of that corner just about every time.
That's his money shot, and Dax is 6'3", but he's got really long arms, and of the two, he's probably the better blocker at the net.
Here comes Steffes, working cross court. Rogers chopping and Jose on the right side. Steffes goes on one. So Kent Steffes. And Steffes' team now with a 6-5 lead.
Kent does it all on this play. He gets a great jump serve off cross court, getting the team in trouble. Then he hits it over on two. Just a great individual effort by Kent.
Holdren and Rogers need to pass a little bit better, especially when they're on the good side. And down the line goes Dax.
You're right, Chris. It's just psychologically damaging when you get over to the good side and say, okay, now let's reel off a couple
let's
points.
Let's get four.
And you make a couple bad passes and you give up points, it just doubles the pressure on you.
Here comes Holdren, trailing by 1-6-5. And a shank pass. I don't know if Loyola thought Kent was coming in, but it went right off his right arm, out of bounds. 2 minutes and 34 seconds to go in game one. Loyola and Steffes 6, Holdren and Rogers 6. We miss you, Mike Dodd. Well, Mike Dodd, you're on every volleyball telecast from here to Podunk. So,
well, they miss me now. They might be sick of me by the end of the season.
That's right. That's right. They'll love you for a while. You're a breath of fresh air. Chris Marlowe and Mike Dodd. And we're your new team on ESPN2. We'll be here for the next five broadcasts. Next five tournaments throughout May and June and July. Dax Holdren right there and his partner Todd Rogers, a team that has never won a tournament, going up against Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola, and we're tied at 6.
Steffes with the patented cross-court bomb. The wind really starting to pick up. You can hear it in our microphones. And Jose and Kent have got to take advantage of that on the good side.
Holdren going over the top and down. When we were talking to Todd Rogers and Dax Holdren earlier, they told us that they had been playing together for about 9 years. They won their first tournament together in Ventura Beach, California. It was a B tournament. That's for all the little bitty guys. Then they moved up to Pismo Beach and won an A. And they have continued on and on. Co-rookies of the year. And now they're playing in a championship final for the second time.
And you know, Chris, if they won a tournament in Ventura, they know how to play in the wind. It doesn't get much windier than out there.
Wind howling here, but I can remember one time when Ventura was blown out. It was about 10 years ago, and I was driving up the freeway from Los Angeles, and I saw like a 50-foot American flag blow over the freeway with pole attached. They said, it's going to be a windy day. Take the good side as Rogers goes over the top and down. Todd Rogers is 24 years old.
He's just a very crafty hitter. You don't realize, he doesn't look like he's putting a lot of effort in it, but he's just chopping it off the hands every time.
Holdren down the middle, working on Steph. 6-6 is our score. And over the top. Holdren looked like he touched it.
He did.
And so Jose will get it back.
That's a break for Steffes Loyola. Kent chops this ball well out of bounds, but Dax just can't pull his hands back in time.
In the old days, that would have been an honor call, but these days with referees and officials, you're supposed to let them call it. Here comes Rogers. Tap, nicely placed. Todd Rogers getting the touch and the kill. Interestingly, in beach volleyball, the man who gets the most kills is not necessarily the best hitter on the beach, is he?
No, he's the guy getting all the serves.
Okay.
And Todd with a great vision of the court.
Now Rogers will serve, and they're serving Steffes relentlessly. Steffes has now 15 kills. Loyola only has 3, but they're not serving Jose Loyola. They don't want to face the wrath of Copacabana Beach.
And Kent, you see him here, he's probably the master of seeing the defensive players taking that peek right before he attacks the ball. But the young players are learning quickly.
Steph is serving on the good side. We're tied at 6 with 1:46 to go. Clock definitely going to be a factor in this one. Steph has the dig, looking to go ahead to 7, and he does. Pretty good bump set by Jose Loyola, too.
A good jump serve gets them started. Rogers has to bump set. They drop off the net, and then Steffes with the dig and the put away. Great elevation for Kent.
So Steffes now up by 1, rips it.
And no one!
And Rogers off the arm of Jose Loyola.
You see Jose grabbing his head. He wants that again. He had an easy dig opportunity, something he picks up probably 9 out of 10 times dropping off the net. He's really gotten very proficient at that skill.
Dax Holdren right there. He lives in Hermosa Beach. He's married. His wife is Jen. He's got a little boy, Kobe, who's 13 months old. And Kobe likes that one right down the line.
Kobe likes it when daddy whips an ace on the bad side right down the line. Kobe just turned 1 a few days ago. My little girl Dominique turned 1 yesterday. Hello to her and Patty. And a lot of kids on the AVP tour now.
7-7, game 1. We're playing to 11, minute 28 to go. If Holdren And Rogers could get a couple more here and make the change. They do get another point. So Holden working on the husband and wife area. No communication.
No communication and great location for Holden. He rips one down the line. Then he freezes Steffes Loyola and whips one down the middle.
And into the net. So 8-7. Holdren and Rogers lead, and if they can get one more, they'll go to the good side and have a good chance to close it out. You look at the aces story, Holdren and Rogers 5, Steffes Loyola zip.
And where Dax and Todd stand right now, they've already won their battle.
Trouble here.
Rogers with the drive. Wow. 14 feet off the net.
A 360 pirouette and the put away. Wow.
360, and he just delivers this ball down the line, Chris. Yep. And that's just a fantastic individual effort. And again, they're on the bad side, and they're putting the pressure on Steffes and Loyola right now.
8-7, Holdren and Rogers by one. Rogers serving. Here comes Steffes, tight set. Steffes bangs it straight down.
Steffes with another patented side out. Great, great position in the match and in the first game for Holdren and Rogers. They're already at 8. They know even if they give up a point, they're going to go over and finish up the match on the good side, at least time-wise.
So
they're in,
three.
They're in great shape.
Steffes trying the shorty into the corner. And the score remains 8-7. So Dax Holdren, who served a couple of aces last time he had the ball.
Back to serve, 8-7.
He didn't start playing competitive volleyball until he was in high school. And they're working on Loyola now. Loyola tapping. And the side out.
You've got Holdren and Rogers doing a little chat with the referee right now. Steffes takes that ball with his hands. He hasn't been setting much with his hands this year. A couple of oohs and ahs from the crowd. Maybe that ball didn't come out very clean.
8-7 for the youngsters of Holdren and Rogers. Steffes and Loyola trying to get to 8-8 and switch sides. Down the middle. There's a good hand set. Todd Rogers, an All-American setter for Ken Preston up at UC Santa Barbara, and he dished that one nicely.
And Holdren and Rogers were also both setters on their high school volleyball team. They said, we just used to set each other every time. Nice deep cross-court hit for Dax.
So Todd Rogers ready to jump. His team ahead 8-7. We're under a minute with 55 seconds to go. Steffes on the run, cut shot, oh yeah! Can't Steffes, slicing.
Nice scramble play for Steffes and Loyola. Again, Todd Rogers getting a great jump serve off on that. Jose diving, setting Steffes, and Steffes with a great cut shot.
Eight, seven, Holdren Rogers. Still ahead in game one. And into the net.
So there's two serving errors for Kent on the good side. You want to try to keep the pressure on. You want to get a great servant, but you want to keep the pressure on too. So it's time is ticking down.
Holdren.
Good.
And Steffes tapping. 40 seconds to play.
Steffes takes a good look at Dax. Making his defensive move a little early, he adjusts, chops it cross court. 40 seconds left, but the clock really is kind of out of play now. There's both teams have to win by two.
Good.
Even if the clock runs out.
Yep.
I had no one.
Rogers, good dig by Steffes. Loyola. Oh, what a set. It's going over. Todd Rogers. Deep over the top and down. So Rogers and Holdren in command here. They're up by one with 27 and a half seconds to go. This point so important. This next one coming up. Jose trying to spin it up right on the net, but he went over the top.
And again, you've got Holdren and Rogers with just great ball control and great shots.
Spinning.
Nobody.
Steffes. Rogers has the dig to go to 9-7 right here. Todd Rogers, cut shot, got it! Oh, no, he missed it! Whoa.
You see Kent breathing a huge sigh of relief. That ball just trickling on top of the net and dropping out of bounds. What a great First of all, you've got Rogers with the great dig deep middle. Then the ball set way off the net. He hits a beautiful cut shot, trickles along the net, and the net actually caused that ball to go out of bounds. If that ball doesn't hit the net, that's down for point number nine.
Just under 18 seconds to go. Holdren and Rogers by one. Rogers tipping it through. So once again, if the clock runs out, you must still win by two. A little different version of the rule we had a couple of years ago when the clock would run out and the team that was ahead would win.
Not in this case. You've got to win by two. And like the first game of the semifinals with Fenoy Moana, Steffes and Loyola won 15-13.
Here comes Steffes. Holdren with a dig. He can put it away. Clock is running. Holdren got it.
That violation point on the board.
And it's a two-point lead. So now they'll switch sides. And with 1.8 seconds to play, Holdren and Rogers may have it locked up. But don't go away. We'll find out right after this. AVP Tour, the Sunkist Open. It's a single elimination format today. Teams play two games to 11 points with a clock of 6 minutes. The third game, if necessary, a tiebreaker. Played to 6 points with a four-minute clock. You must win by two, and if you lose a match, you're out of the tournament. This is our championship final. Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers are on the brink of winning game one. They all but have it locked up unless one of them falls down and croaks right now. Holdren will serve with 1 8/10 to go.
And he's just going to hit this ball up in the air. The clock's going to run out. And there you've got the first game to Holdren and Rogers.
So count the ace. Albeit, Steffes and Loyola let it go. And Todd Rogers and Dax Holdren take a step closer to their first professional win ever. But keep in mind, it's the best two out of three games. Holdren and Rogers lead one game to none. We'll come back game two. More continuing action from Dallas right after this. Signals working perfectly in game one. As Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers won it 10-7, utilizing six aces. So we figure Steffes and Loyola will come out with renewed vigor, and Steffes and Loyola start on the good side, their choice.
Six aces and three blocks for Holdren and Rogers. They're beating them at the net, the area where Steffes and Loyola usually dominate, and that was the difference in the match.
So Kent Steffes will serve it up into the wind, and right down the middle, ace. So Steffes and Loyola, who got off to a bad start and trailed, then caught up.
Interesting psychological point of the match for the young team. They win the first game. You really want to try to come out and continually to keep the pressure on, and sometimes you just let up and they get blown out that second game.
Little tap shot, Steffes couldn't get there, so give the kill to Dax Holdren. Dax Holdren now living and training in Herbosa Beach, California. He won $67,000 last year. And now his partner Todd Rogers will serve. Loyola beat one cross court.
Great blast for Loyola. Again, the team of Holdren and Rogers, not so physical. You're playing them during the match, you think, I've got things under control, but all of a sudden it's 8-all and there's little time on the board.
Boy, they're really playing deep. And Loyola saw it, so he snuck a shorty in there. Rogers, Loyola has it. Looking for a point on the left, Jose.
Rogers up on the roof.
You know, sometimes it's tough to hit against the shorter player also. Loyola going for the cross-court crank all the way.
Sometimes you see you have the shorter player up there, you drop your arm, and what happens? Rogers blocks that ball straight down.
1-0, Steffes Loyola. With this win, it's got to be a 3-1 ratio. If you want to win a game, you better get three or four on the good side. And if you could just get a point on the bad side, or maybe two, if you get two, you'd be feeling really good, wouldn't you, Mike?
I think when you've got the four-point sides, if you get 1 point, you're kind of even. If you get two or more, you've won the battle.
Good side is the side Kent Steffes is on now. And really serving into a stiff wind. And Jose's got an easy one. Wind blowing it backwards. And a point. Loyola and Steffes two. Holdren and Rogers nothing.
Steffes coming back to
Steffes serve. And Loyola with 2 points, but they've actually had four straight scoring opportunities. So if they're starting to transition, starting to convert, it could have been 4-0.
Working on Holzer. Stephens, a little karate, goes into the crowd.
Side out on play.
And the side out back to the youngsters.
Kent caught a little bit out of position on that play, had his feet moving, had his hands moving, wasn't really set for the defense.
Todd Rogers and Dax Holgren, who played every tournament together last year with the exception of one. Rogers got hurt, and Dax Holgren played a tournament with Kevin Long. And that's going to be a side out as Kent Steffes puts it away.
Loyola back to serve, 2-0.
So Jose Loyola will have the ball. Loyola, the 1997 King of the Beach, did not play quite as well this year in Las Vegas. And the King of the Beach title going to Eric Fanoy Moana. That was a big payday, too, for Fanoy. Good. He is the leading money winner on tour.
And no one.
As we play here in Dallas. Jose, nice dig. Jose looking for the big bopper. And he crunches it. Loyola and Steffes have a lot of, they got good chemistry, but a lot of confidence.
A lot of confidence and just two extremely physical athletes. They can play the game, they can play the defense, they can transition, they can block. It makes for a very difficult opponent when you don't have a lot of weaknesses, and they don't have a lot.
Loyola serving Rogers. It's 3-0 now. And so as you might have suggested, Mike, Loyola and Steffes with renewed enthusiasm get off to a very quick start at 4-0. We're going to take a short timeout. We're coming back to the Sunkist Open in Dallas right after this. We left you with Steffes and Loyola leading 4-0. We now pick up action at 9-3. Back in Dallas, Texas, the Sunkist Open. Our championship final is 2 out of 3, single elimination. Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers, one game, 110-7. This is game two. Kent Steffes, Jose Loyola, all over the kids at 9-3. I'm Chris Marlowe, my partner, one of the great players of all time, Mike Dodd, nursing the shoulder injury. What's been the key in this game?
I think the key is just Steffes and Loyola settling down a little bit, not getting blocked, not getting aced as many times, and letting their defense and their blocking do the talking.
Now, Rogers and Holdren back on the good side. And they're having trouble with their serves now. The wind has been howling all day. The temperature on the Swatch timer is 95 degrees. The conditions have been rigorous for the players all weekend. But both teams in this final came in equally rested, one of the benefits of single elimination. So there is no big disadvantage of struggling and playing, you know, 8 or 9 matches in the losers bracket for one team.
Exactly. Jose serving wide there. And it's almost to the point now, Holdren and Rogers are down by 6, 2 minutes left. They want to just try to get some momentum to go into the third game.
Would there ever be a point where Rogers and Holdren just say, let's just give them the next two here. We'll save our energy and put all of our energy into game three.
I think there's definitely a point it'll come to that. They might be at that point right now. It just depends how tired they're feeling.
Okay.
But obviously, if you're really at the end of your tank,
and not able to go on, it would be better to do that. Jose Loyola, suddenly it's 10-3.
Another great serve by Steffes down the middle. Block for Loyola. And if you're at the end of your tank, it doesn't make sense to try to battle back in this game. You're down 10-3. At a certain point, you got to say, oh, maybe we should get this one over with and conserve our energy and use it up in the final game.
First game point for Steffes Loyola.
I'll take serve into the top of the net.
Once again, 95 degrees, and it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Dallas time, so that's hot. It's not really humid. It's a hot, dry heat, much like Las Vegas heat. If you've ever been there and not been in the casino. Here comes Steffes. Little coverage there, and tapping down the line is Jose Loyola.
Nice cover by Jose, and you know, Texas in May, if you want to see changes in the weather, it could be 90 degrees, or, you know, 5 minutes later, it could be hailing. You never know.
Jose Loyola, second game point for his squad. And he got it. And that will do it for game two.
That's called making a statement. Loyola and Steffes lose the first game. They come out, make a big statement in the second, saying, You want your first win, you got to come and get us.
We are tied at one game apiece. We'll come back the third and deciding game right after this.
Back in beautiful Dallas, Texas, Jose Loyola and Kent Steffes just 3 points away from victory. The two teams split the first two games. This is the third and final game. And Holdren and Rogers may be out of gas a bit. They're on the good side, but they're trailing 3-0. A little bit frustrated. They need a big comeback. And Rogers over the top and out. So Steffes and Loyola, as they did in game two, really applying a lot of pressure. And they lead it 4-0. Steffes and Loyola are controlling the action. We're going to come back to Dallas in a minute. Can they wrap it up? They need two more points to win the championship here in Dallas. Welcome back to the Sunkist Open at Dallas, Texas. Chris Marlowe and Mike Dodd. 4-0 is our score. The fans have stayed around to watch Todd Rogers and Dax Holdren, the youngsters, trying for the upset on the veterans, Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola. It looks like Loyola and Steffes are going to wrap it up, though. They lead 4-0, and they've got the kids in trouble. Nice play by Rogers. Rogers and Holdren looked very good in game one. Very strong, very powerful, serving a lot of aces, but Steffes and Loyola able to turn it around in game two.
Most definitely, and the key to Holdren and Rogers in game one was that they were scoring points on the bad side. They got a couple aces on the bad side. If they're going to have a chance in this final game, they've got to do something special right now.
Shank pass, Loyola goes and gets it. Great save there. Steffes on the left, he likes it there, and he chops it down. And Steffes and Jose Loyola making the hustle plays.
Huge break for Steffes and Loyola. That serve wasn't that difficult. Steffes just shanks the ball, but luckily it catches the bottom of the net, gives Jose time to set him up. They cover themselves. And Steffes, it's a little cut here, putting it away. Big break for Steffes Loyola.
4-0, playing to six. Todd Rogers, Steffes almost had it. Got a handful of sand and didn't quite come up with it. So Holdren and Rogers will have it back. Both of them from Santa Barbara. Of course, there have been a lot of great volleyball players over the years come out of Santa Barbara, California, going all the way back to Henry Bergman.
Henry Bergman and Karch Karai doesn't get much better than those two.
Absolutely. A couple of guys that can hit the ball straight down. John Stevenson, another fellow who couldn't hit very well, but he was a good player. Here's Todd Rogers. And the ball hit out of bounds. Just kidding about John Stevenson. He's working our stats today, and we appreciate that.
Todd Rogers very frustrated right now. His last two plays, his side out, and then this last defensive opportunity, he ran underneath the ball. He made his approach too early, couldn't see the court, and just chucked it out of bounds. That was a big point for those guys.
152 remaining in this third game, and Loyola serving with a 4-0 lead. Todd Rogers thumping it through. What a moral victory would it be if they could just get a point or get a couple and get over on the good side.
Just get 1 point at this juncture and get yourself over to the good side and give yourself a chance.
Here comes Jose. And that ball is out of bounds. You know, Mike, I think back to 1993 in Arizona when you and Tim Hovland were down to Kenton Karch, 6-1, and I was packing up my notes and doing my sign-off, and all of a sudden,
you were about ready to officially close the beach.
I was closing the beach, and you guys made the most fantastic comeback, maybe in AVP volleyball history, so it's not out of the realm of possibility. Back over, Steffes, down 4-1.
Well, this will be a great comeback in itself, and Rogers and Holdren have had great point opportunities the last three times. They've converted once. If they can side out a couple more times to get two, they're still in the game.
Experience or fatigue, they're not able to put those away.
Probably a little bit of both at this juncture.
Steffes serving 4-1. Holdren and Rogers trying to hang on. Steffes is right there on the left. And Rogers has the dig. Chance to save a point. Todd Rogers, cut shot, got it. Wow. That was a tired-looking shot by Kent Steffes. He likes to get sandy, and he doesn't brush it off. He's a lot like Pigpen. You know Pigpen in the
exactly
in the Peanuts?
Yeah, he likes to be dirty out there on the court. Yeah. He likes to play dirty, play hard, and there's a little bit of fatigue on both sides, I think, right now. It's very hot. It's been a long weekend. Todd Rogers on his last three or four approaches has seemed a little bit less on his jump.
They'll work on Kent Steffes. And Steffes whacks it out. I think right now, if I'm Rogers and Holdren, I'm working on Steffes when I get that ball back. So Rogers and Holdren are not out of it yet. They trail 4-2, but they're going to the good side.
And they're keeping the pressure on. And the last 4 points, Chris, have been on errors. Not digs, not blocks, but just balls being hit out of bounds. So it might come down to who's going to have the best concentration when they're really tired.
And a timeout taken. We've talked about the single elimination format. You know, some say you don't get enough games in, but if you get to Sunday, you get to the final day, you could play a lot of games. You could play 9 games. So it's really a test on Sunday for some of these players.
It really is. You've got your quarterfinal match, your semifinal, and your final. If each one goes 3, those are 9 games. That's a long, hard Sunday. And a lot of people say, well, if you have double elimination, the endurance factor is still there. If you have single elimination, it takes the endurance out, and that's not the case.
The number one team on tour is Jose Loyal and Kent Steffes, followed by Adam Johnson, Karch Garai, Canyon Seaman and Whitmarsh, Blanton Fenoy, Hyger and Tanner. Good to see Troy Tanner back on tour. Dax Holdren and Rogers figure to move up. Bouillon Clark, Lewis and Swat, a good finish this week, I should say.
Taking
and Brent Frohaw. So Todd Rogers will serve, trailing 4-2. And Loyola pumps it through. Yesterday, Rogers and Holdren were down 5-1 in a game 3 against Russell and Cairns and beat them.
Came back and win. And those are the type of comebacks that you need to set you up to win, make your big comeback and win your first tournament.
This is the third and final game once again. Playing to 6 points for the championship. And Rogers walks it down the line. You know, when you see a shot like that, you say to yourself, well, why doesn't Jose run over there? Well, he's dug in up to his knees.
He's dug in looking for the heater cross court.
Yeah.
But right now, if I'm Jim Mingus, the coach of Jose and Kent, I notice that Todd Rogers' legs
not hitting.
Are going.
Yeah, he's not hitting. So you got to be ready to move. They'll serve Jose 4-2. And Holdren can't bring it up. I'm really surprised they're not working on Steffes. Steffes hit a ball out, and you go back to that, Mike. If a guy hits a ball out or into the net, you serve him again. And serve him again.
Yeah, until he proves himself.
Till the tongue falls out of his mouth. You keep serving him, right?
I think we've got 4 tongues out there right now that are starting to lap up the sand.
4-2. If you can make him eat sand, that's even better. Here comes Todd Rogers. And Steffes has one on a guide shot.
Ooh, Jose must have touched that just barely on the block.
Holdren. And Holdren hit it out. So a couple of tired-looking shots by Rogers and Holdren. And Steffes and Loyola have a championship point coming up.
You mentioned fatigue earlier, and I wasn't quite sure, but fatigue is definitely showing its ugly face right now toward the end of this match.
Can't Steffes serving for the championship? No. Quick timeout taken by Rogers and Holdren. So Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola figure they are in command with a 3-point lead. Let's listen if we can.
Jose says, you serve, I block.
Yeah? I block his face. I stuff him. I stuff his face. Let's see if he can do it. So Steffes back out.
I tell you, this is the part of beach volleyball that I really love. When you get down to the wire, you get guys that are all really tired, and then it comes down to will. And beach volleyball has always been such a game of your personal will, how much you're willing to endure to push through the fatigue.
First championship point. They'll work on Todd Rogers. Rogers looping. Ooh, he nibbled the line for a side out. 38 seconds to go. So Holdren and Rogers really have to thump now. They've got to get some points quickly.
They got to get some points and make some big plays. And that was a big play right there. Steffes with a great match point cross-court jump serve. Rogers laying out and making the pass and siding out.
See who Rogers goes to. Will they work on Steffes right there? He's huffing and puffing a bit. They do. Kent. Doug, back over to Jose. Perfect set. See you later. Jose is pumped up. One thing, Steffes and Loyola, they have a lot of energy together. They get much more pumped up than, say, Kent and Karch used to, or Angino and Loyola.
Well, I think Kent had to take a different role with Jose. He had to be kind of the spark guy, and they feed off each other.
Second championship point for Steffes Loyola. Rogers looking to terminate quickly. No, this could be it. Steffes on the right. No! But still, the clock was running. So we only have 20 and a half seconds remaining in this game.
If they lose this match, Kent's going to look back at this play and say, I just wanted to keep that ball in and keep that clock running. You hit the ball in the net, the clock stops. Could be a very costly error if Rogers and Holdren come back and score a couple points here.
Dax Holdren down 5-2. Got to get it in. He does, working on Steffes. And Steffes hanging in and punching it cross court. If you're wondering in terms of clock, the average side out takes about 4.5 to 5 seconds max on a good pass set crunch.
So there's only two or three left here.
Third championship point, Kent Steffes.
Rogers and Holdren really want to side out cleanly and not get involved in a long rally. That's going to kill the clock.
Got to punch it fast, and they do. Side out. So Dax Holdren and Todd Rogers, they need a miracle. It can happen with serving. We've seen some amazing things happen with clock and with aces. Remember the one time Adam Johnson and his partner were down by two with 1 second to go, and they tied it up and sent it into overtime with a quick ace.
And at this point, they don't need to tie it up. They just need to get to 1 point. So it's 5-2. They've got to find a way to score a quick point and then give themselves a chance to get the fourth.
Got to get a point with time left on the clock.
And you see Jose just bumping that ball high.
And that's going to do it. Clock has run down to 3.7. Loyola and Steffes will serve. That'll take some of the time off the clock, maybe all of it.
But they're basically celebrating the tournament now, Chris, because they've got the serve. There's only 3 seconds left. They're going to hit a very high serve. It's going to take at least 2 to 3 seconds just to get the ball back over the net. And this tournament's over. Kent and Jose have won another tournament.
And going on one, good play by Rogers, and it's going out of bounds, but the clock has expired. And Jose Loyola and Kent Steffes win again. Win number three on the Miller Lite AVP Tour.
That's three in a row for Kent and Jose. You see Jose putting up the number one sign for this weekend. And you gotta feel good for Rogers and Holdren. They played a tough tournament. It was very difficult conditions. They took another second. They haven't made it over the hump, but they know the hump's in front of them, and it's only a matter of time. You got to give them credit.
So the champions of the Sunkissed Open in Dallas, Texas, Kent Steffes and Jose Loyola. We'll come back. We'll have more for you from the Big D right after this.